Good evening. For those of you who don't know, the Lakers just did win. Miss Stacey Zumiak will now lead us in singing the national anthem. Miss Zumiak is one of our own Collins College students.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rockets, a red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Please be seated. Thank you, Stacey, for that moving performance.
Thank you.
I am Andy Feinstein, Dean of the Collins College of Hospitality Management. Welcome to our 2009 commencement. On behalf of the faculty, staff, and students of the college, I offer congratulations to our graduates and a special welcome to their families and friends who join us here today. This year marks the 35th anniversary since Cal Poly Pomona first began offering hospitality classes. This lineage gives us the special distinction of being the oldest and largest hospitality management program in California. Many students have come before you and made important inroads, both nationally and abroad, in this fine industry. But there is something that makes you special right off the bat. Last summer, President Ortiz granted our recommendation to be elevated from a school to a college. This designation places us among only a few hospitality management colleges nationwide, and we're the only college of its kind in the state of California. Well, you graduates are the first graduating class of the Collins College of Hospitality Management. You and the college are in essence graduating today. Congratulations. It gives me great pleasure to introduce the distinguished members of the platform party. I ask that each of them stand as I read their names, but please hold your applause until they have all been introduced. Dr. J. Michael Ortiz, President of California State Polytechnic University Pomona. Dr. Martin Den Boer, Provost and Vice President for Academic Affairs. Trustee Russell Statham, member of the California State University Board of Trustees. Mr. Jim Collins, a founding member of the college's Board of Advisors. Mr. Richard N. Frank, a founding member of the college's Board of Advisors, who you will be hearing a little bit more about late in a little bit. Ms. Talia Lawson, our 2009 Outstanding Scholar. Ms. Lara Zelenskaya, our Julian A. McPhee Scholar. Ms. Nadine Liao, President of the Hospitality Management Council and our Senior Class Representative. Mr. Michael Godfrey, Associate Dean for the Collins College of Hospitality Management. Dr. Douglas Freer, Vice President for Student Affairs. Dr. Ed Barnes, Vice President for Administrative Affairs, Mr. Scott Warrington, Vice President for University Advancement, Dr. John Self, Academic Senator for the Collins College of Hospitality Management. Thank you all very much for being with us. Please be seated. Now, I would like to introduce some special guests who are here with us today. Mrs. Betty Ortiz, the President's wife, Cal Poly Pomona's First Lady. Mrs. Carol Collins. Mrs. Mary Alice Frank. Ms. Sandra Davis, Executive Assistant President's Office. Mr. Art Barajas, President of the Cal Poly University Alumni Association and 2006 Collins College Distinguished Alumnus, and his wife, Luann. Mr. Stephen Senft, Class of 1998 and President of the Alumni Chapter for the Collins College of Hospitality Management. Thank you for joining our celebration today. I would now like to welcome President Ortiz to say a few words. President Ortiz?
Greetings, graduates. Welcome to one of the most memorable days of your life. Winston Churchill once said that there is nothing more exhilarating than to set a great and noble goal and to blow right through it on the way to achieving more than anyone thought possible. Many of you never imagined that you could achieve a college degree, and today we boldly celebrate that achievement. And just as importantly, look forward to the new ones that will follow. Now, I'm sure that a handful of you are pondering an ambiguous future. These are difficult times, and our economic and business climate is dramatically different than when you entered Cal Poly Pomona. But you have an opportunity that was unavailable to generations past. You can build a new and different future for California in the industry that can turn our state around. We need college graduates that are innovative, clever, entrepreneurial in spirit. As college graduates, you have responsibilities. One of those is to protect the educational experience that was provided to you. Each of you needs to take responsibility for the gift you received. Help keep the doors of opportunity open to those students who follow in your footsteps. Let your friends, colleagues, legislators, and community know how important the California State University and Cal Poly Pomona are to you. The 1,000 plus voices in our audience today can play a crucial role in the future of the Golden State, giving the next generation that opportunity for success. We can collectively accomplish great things. That's why it's important to stay connected to your alma mater through the Cal Poly Pomona Alumni Association. Through the Alumni Association, you can communicate with the university and with your classmates. There are flyers with details on how to join, as well as how to obtain a free gift, a DVD of today's ceremony. Before I go, let me pay special attention to Steve Quintero, the 2009 Commencement Committee, and all of the volunteers, including those in the video streaming tents. Currently, we have about 92 countries that are tuning in to our event. But it would not be possible without the efforts of those individuals, so please join me in celebrating their work. I want to leave you today with some insights on life from one of our country's great poets. His real name is Theodore Geisel, but most of us know him as Dr. Seuss. And the poem goes like this. My uncle ordered popovers from the restaurant's bill of fare, and when they were served, he regarded them with a penetrating stare. Then he spoke great words of wisdom as he sat there on that chair. To eat these things, said my uncle, you must exercise great care. You may swallow down what's solid, but you must spit out the air. And as you partake in the world's bill of fare, that's darn good advice to follow. Do a lot of spitting out the hot air, and be careful what you swallow. Please accept my heartfelt congratulations on this achievement and have a great day.
Thank you, President Ortiz. It is now my pleasure to introduce Mr. Russell Statham, a member of the California State University Board of Trustees. We are happy to have you with us, Trustee.
Thank you, Dean Feinstein. It's truly a pleasure for me to be here, and I want to bring warm greetings on behalf of the Board of Trustees of the California State University. We are truly honored and excited that you are joining the ranks of our alumni. I'd like to encourage you and really amplify the message that President Ortiz gave you about our continued support of the university and its mission. We really, in these economic times, must work together to keep the doors of opportunity open for the students who follow in your footsteps. Soon after graduating and entering the workforce, you will realize the real benefits of earning a degree from the California State University. And as you enter that workforce and join the 90,000 other students who are graduating in this commencement season across the California State University, you will realize the true benefits that degree provides. As a citizen and a member of our community, we encourage you to continue to support the California State University by helping those in need, giving direction to those who wish to enter college, and telling them how you got to where you are. Finally, as a graduate of the California State University, we encourage you to be an ambassador for our system. Go out and tell your friends, your colleagues, your legislators, and indeed all in your community just how important the California State University was to you. We hope that in doing this, we will help to spread our message of importance and keep the doors of opportunity open. Again, congratulations and best wishes for the future. Thank you.
I would now like to introduce Nadine Liao, the senior class representative from the Collins College of Hospitality Management, who will present the senior class gift to President Ortiz. Nadine is an excellent student who has been actively involved on campus. This past year, she served as HMC president and director of communications for our CMAA student chapter. The chapter has been the national student chapter of the year for 2 years straight. Nadine?
President Ortiz, Dean Feinstein, members of the stage party, distinguished guests, and my fellow members of the graduating class of 2009. It is a tradition at Cal Poly Pomona for us, the graduating class, to leave behind not only great memories and awesome friends, but also a gift to our campus and to the future students at our alma mater, Cal Poly Pomona. It is the gift from the class of 2009 is the new benches in front of the recently renovated university library. President Ortiz, it is my pleasure to present to you, on behalf of the graduating class of 2009, our gift to our alma mater, Cal Poly Pomona. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Nadine. I know that the location of these benches will not only benefit the future generations of students at Cal Poly Pomona, but also the entire Cal Poly Pomona family. Thank you, class of 2009.
Each year at commencement, the Collins College of Hospitality Management honors the student with the highest grade point average in the graduating class as its outstanding scholar. Ms. Talia Lawson has proven her ability to achieve academic excellence with a grade point average of 3.88. This is an incredible accomplishment. Talia is a member of the Kellogg's Honors College and Eta Sigma Delta, which is the Honor Society for the hospitality industry. She has also been active with the Cal Poly Hospitality Association. Talia decided at a young age, during a trip to Japan, that she wanted to work in the hotel business. We are happy that her interests led her to us. I would like to recognize Talia Lawson's family, who I am sure are very proud of her today. Will Talia's family please stand and be recognized?
Thank you, Dean Feinstein. 4 years ago, I came to this campus on orientation day. I remember standing at the bottom of the staircase leading up to the Collins College. At the time, it was 90 degrees, and I was a part of a pack of sweaty freshmen shuffling our way up the staircase. At the time, we couldn't think of a reason for spending years climbing those stairs day after day, and for that matter, something that will make it worthwhile. But each of us here today found that reason. So let us take a moment to stop and thank those who inspired us to make that climb each day. Thank you to our staff and faculty of the Collins College. Thank you for sharing your knowledge and your personal stories, for taking the time out of your day to help us, or just to lend a friendly ear. Without you, we wouldn't be able to develop the ideas and goals that we are walking away with. Thank you also to our friends and family. Thank you for being there with us when we were trying to figure out the cost per pound of shredded cabbage at 3 a.m. Thank you for giving us a place to live when we lost our jobs or forgot to reapply for campus housing, which is something I blame entirely on HRT 383 and the time I spent in the kitchen. Thank you so much for listening to us on the phone when it seemed that work and school was too much to handle. We wouldn't be here before you today without the support and guidance you gave us each step of the way. We all joined the Collins College for different reasons. Some of us were inspired by time spent in the kitchen with our loved ones, others by trips and stays in hotels around the world or across town. But whether it was love of food, of travel, or simply the lure of human contact, we are all joined by one ideal, hospitality. The dictionary defines hospitality as hospitable treatment, reception, or disposition. But for those of us graduating today, hospitality isn't just some definition in a book. It is a way of life. We were lucky these past years to be surrounded by individuals who value the concept of hospitality. But when we leave here today, we're entering a world that doesn't necessarily hold that same value. It is easy to lose sight of why we took up the challenges of this profession when there is a guest yelling at us because they forgot the dates of their reservation or their food took too long to reach the table. Just remember to keep a love of hospitality and a joy in your profession close to your heart. I don't want to stand up here today and give you a list of cliches in response to our graduation. I'm sure everybody knows that over our college years, we've blossomed like flowers, and no doubt we'll spread our wings and fly. After all, today is the first day of the rest of our lives, isn't it? While these may all be true, let us relate our graduation to something a little more familiar to us, something that has, in its own way, come to represent the Collins College of Hospitality Management, our favorite staircase up the mountain. After today, we will no longer have to climb those stairs to get to class. But we will be climbing a staircase of a different sort. What awaits us at the top isn't 2 hours of lecture, group project meetings, or the dinner shift at the RKR, but rather the achievements of our personal and professional goals. Keep the concepts of hospitality we've learned here in your hearts, and remember, this evening, we are walking away with more than just a piece of paper. We are walking away with the knowledge, connections, and friendships that will stay with us for the rest of our lives. Thank you.
Thank you, Talia. Lara, will you please join me at the podium? Now, it is my pleasure to present the Julian A. McPhee Award for Student Excellence, named after the founding president of Cal Poly Pomona and Cal Poly San Luis Obispo. The McPhee Award is given in recognition of a student's outstanding academic achievement and service to their college. This year's recipient has served as a Collins College ASI Senator, the conference planner for CMAA Chapter, president of Eta Sigma Delta, and she was selected for the Banffy Wine Scholarship, which includes an all-expense-paid trip to Italy this summer. I've done that, it's quite nice. Our recipient has accepted full-time employment with Codalera Country Club to begin a week after graduation in Edwards, Colorado. it is my pleasure to introduce to you our 2009 Julian A. McPhee Award recipient, Ms. Lara Zelenskaya. President Ortiz, will you please join us at the podium?
Thank you, Dean Feinstein and President Ortiz. This is an astonishing honor for me to receive the Julian McPhee Award. This award represents all the people that have shaped my college experience for the past 4 years of my life. I'd like to thank my dad, my brother, and my mom for being understanding and tolerating my constant absences from home. Professors Neha Singh and Margie Jones for continuously challenging me and thus believing in me. And my Collins College family away from home. Nadine, Mike Levin, and Sean Z have always been there for me, and I could have never wished for better support in my life. We all had taken time to get here today. As we know, big part of what made this time special today is the people, the relationships we have created. As we will walk away today with our own degrees, we really should keep in mind we did this together. A classmate who saved you a seat at the first club general meeting, a new college friend who asked you to join them for lunch at the fast food line, a professor who called you a chicken for being not able to speak up your mind, or a staff member who attended your presentation during their time off, and even a loved one who have helped you to grow as a person and become a stronger individual. All these people that I have met at the Collins College taught me more than I could have ever learned in the classroom. Such learning opportunities exist at Collins College on a daily basis. We are Collins family, and we look after each other as responsible family members should do. So let us keep doing so after today. Today is a capstone of our lives, a capstone that your family, friends, and loved ones are here to celebrate with you. I am proud of us. I feel honored to have such bright, intelligent, competent, and passionate fellow students come out of the best hospitality program. So let me hear you celebrate. Ooh, ooh! Thank you, and enjoy your night.
Congratulations, Lara. Today, we are honored to recognize an individual whose profound success in the American restaurant industry will be an inspiration to graduates who are about to make their mark in the world of hospitality. Mr. Richard N. Frank is a pioneer in the restaurant industry and a longtime supporter of the Collins College. With more than 50 years of experience running Lowry's Foods and Lowry's Restaurants, Inc., Mr. Frank has set the bar high for quality dining in the United States. The longevity of his company spans generations because he is committed to providing a superior dining experience. He is a man of great success and strong principles. As a result, I ask that President Ortiz, Trustee Statham, and Mr. Frank come forward to the podium for the conferral of the honorary degree.
As one of the nation's most successful entrepreneurs, Richard N. Frank has helped to build a business into a company whose reputation for excellence is known around the world. He is the chairman of Lowry's Restaurant Incorporated, a family-owned enterprise consisting of award-winning restaurants in the United States and throughout Asia. In addition to guiding the growth of the family restaurant company, Mr. Frank has served as president and CEO of Lowry's Foods Incorporated, which produces some 100 products, including Lowry's seasoned salt, America's best-selling formulated seasoning. Under his innovative leadership, Lowry's Foods Incorporated grew from a fledgling family business into a $150 million company that has made the Lowry's name and its fanciful L trademark famous from coast to coast and indeed throughout the world. In 2008, Frank was awarded one of the highest honors the restaurant industry can bestow, the California Restaurant Association's Lifetime Achievement Award. The award recognized Frank as, quote, an extraordinary individual who has transformed the restaurant and hospitality industries through his innovation, influenced the industry with his contributions of lasting significance, shown significance and demonstrated vision to the industry, demonstrated notable and exemplary service to the community, and served as an exceptional leader whose passion and dedication have inspired others. Dedicated philanthropists, Frank and his wife, Mary Alice Frank, continue to make many important contributions to the industry and the community and this university, especially in education. He is an emeritus trustee at the Pomona College in Claremont, California, the Art Center College of Design in Pasadena, California, and a member of the Board of Advisors of the College, Collins College of Hospitality Management at Cal Poly Pomona, where he established and endowed a lectureship series that was established in 1988 to allow students a unique opportunity to hear directly from the industry's leaders and legends as they bring hospitality management to life through their own real-world experiences. In recognition of these and his many other accomplishments, the California State University Board of Trustees and Cal Poly Pomona are proud to confer on Richard N. Frank the honorary degree of Doctor of Humane Letters. President Ortiz, will you please confer the degree?
By the authority vested in me as President of California State Polytechnic University Pomona, I confer upon you, Richard N. Frank, with all the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters, with all the rights, honors, and opportunities it conveys. It is an ancient custom to invest those who receive academic degrees with hoods that designate their degree bestowed. I will now make that investiture.
I'm not sure I know who the person was that they were talking about a minute or two ago. Those of you who have been fortunate to have experienced a milestone as I am experiencing at this moment know that you were overwhelmed and humbled. Without doubt, this honor has to be the top acknowledgement and recognition I have received in my long life. I guess I can say it's a thrill of a lifetime. Thank you, thank you. I never expected to receive an honorary doctorate, especially one from an institution for which I have such affection. Although I never attended the Collins College, I feel like an enthusiastic alumnus. This place has become that close to me. I don't remember who called me that day many years ago, asking if I would be willing to attend a meeting to discuss the new hotel and restaurant program at Cal Poly Pomona. I came close to saying no, until Al Levy and Jim Collins were mentioned as backers and prime movers. Both men were friends and prominent in the local hospitality industry, Al in the meat business and Jim the franchisee of Colonel Sanders' chicken chain. If they were interested and involved in the program, it had to be a worthwhile venture. Being a graduate of nearby Pomona College, I was also familiar with Cal Poly, and in any event, I agreed to attend. We met in an undistinguished room somewhere here on campus. Besides Al and Jim, several others were there, including the then president of the university, Hugh Labonte. He was a genial, friendly person whom I took an immediate liking, and his support of the program cemented my interest in it. We have come a long way since then, from a fledgling program attached to the business school to a school to a college, which has achieved national renown and recognition. In the interim, I have enjoyed making many new friends. In addition to the faculty, I want to mention former Dean Bob Small and the new Dean Andy Feinstein. Both have been and continue to be instrumental in the development of the college. Most of all, I am impressed with Cal Poly's current president, Michael Ortiz. Mike is a great educator and leader, and I'm especially pleased to call him a personal friend. I've always had an interest, a keen interest in education, primarily higher education. I've been active among a number of institutions, and I'm an emeritus trustee of my alma mater, Pomona College. Being a member of the Collins College of Board of Advisors has been particularly enjoyable and fulfilling. Life is like a menu, to use an appropriate term here, a menu of many choices and decisions. My father told me at an early age that an individual makes only a handful of key decisions in his or her lifetime that are of signal importance. A person has no control over their gender, where they come from, or the name they are given. You can guess what these key decisions might be, but among them are where you go to school, what career you select, whom you marry, and so on. Attending and graduating from the college has to be among those few key ones you will make. You must be enormously proud of your achievement, and I salute and congratulate you for it, as well as your parents, grandparents, sisters, and brothers. It is indeed a significant and happy day for all of us. In closing, I want to again express my great and sincere appreciation for the honor you've bestowed on me. Thank you.
Congratulations on your degree, and thank you, Dr. Frank, for that wonderful speech. I will now call upon Provost and Vice President for Academic Affairs, Martin Den Boer, to present the candidates for the baccalaureate degree. Provost Den Boer?
Will the candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Hotel and Restaurant Management please rise? That means all of you. President Ortiz, I present to you the candidates for the baccalaureate degree from the Collins College of Hospitality Management. These candidates have all completed the requirements for the baccalaureate degree as prescribed by the State of California and the trustees of the California State University, and they have been recommended for their degrees by the faculty of California State Polytechnic University, Pomona.
Candidates for the baccalaureate degree. You have heard the recommendation of the faculty of California State Polytechnic University, Pomona. By the authority vested in me as president, I confer upon you the degree of Bachelor of Science in Hotel and Restaurant Management, with all the rights, honors, and opportunities appertaining thereto. Congratulations. In academic tradition, the student who has not yet earned a degree wears the tassel of the mortarboard on the right side. When the degree is conferred, the scholar moves the tassel to the left and joins a select company. In recognition of your new status, will all recipients of the baccalaureate degree move the tassel to the left?
To the class of 2009, I commend you for your effort and accomplishments. Please be seated. I now ask our outstanding scholar, McPhee Scholar, and senior class representative to lead the lineup of their classmates for the baccalaureate presentation. and I ask that the students follow the staff's direction to the lineup. Will the faculty participating in the presentation please take your places on stage? Now, will the faculty please move to the base of the stage to greet our 2009 graduates?
Kellogg Scholar, Lara Zelenskaya, magna cum laude.
Talia Lawson, Kellogg Scholars, summa cum laude.
Kathy Lee. Pete David Favata.
Shannon Renee Gilbert.
Diego Ramirez.
Karen Wong, cum laude.
Frank Vasquez. Mary Rose De Los Reyes Lampino.
Candy W. Ng.
Lisa Marie Casillas.
Rogelio Aceves Torres.
Stephanie Kiyoko Ida.
Catherine Chu.
Tony Fan.
Xiaodan Tracy Tong.
Subin Young.
Sarith Pot.
Annie Chen.
Lawrence G.
Estela Serra Munoz.
Joey Kang Sa.
Vicky Minyoung Kim.
Lance Remington Stewart Rude.
Julie Yukiko Imatomi.
Jessica Olivia Lopez.
Charlene Shea.
Ariane Ashley Abayan Estepa.
Amy Renee Miller.
Jessica Ray Wellwood.
Amber Christine Graves.
Woldy Reyes.
Jamie Lynn Domingo.
Anne Margaret Doucette.
Nadine Liao.
Kristen Cheryl Harmel, cum laude.
Barbara Lee.
Crystal Siobhan Bronson.
Brian Leung.
Jarius Figueroa Chang.
Hiroko Kumada.
Julia Lai.
Azusa Kosaka.
Annabelle Hong.
Eriko Miyakawa.
Julie Elizabeth Maidenberg.
Chung Hyun Cho.
Michael Anthony Feeder.
Andrew Aun.
Stephen Cool.
Mosi Ferguson Patton.
Wendy Heehan.
Baldomero Roel.
Heather Francis Strayer.
Brent Leroy Grimm.
Janelle Valerie Chrysostomo.
Michael David Levin.
Alice Pui Ying Hung.
David Allen Little.
Marifel Torreflores Parco.
Jonathan Danielson, cum laude.
Holly Gail Krikorian.
Benjamin Dennis White.
Lindsay Nicole Scott.
Sarah Jane Carazzi.
Kyle Ken Psyche.
Felicidad Marie Buenavente Nierva.
Dominic Noel Fisher.
Juliana Chen.
Kate Elizabeth Zahortz.
Kartik Patel.
Sydney Ray Mortar.
Cynthia Carolina Mesa.
Barbara Rodriguez.
Quentin Chan.
Crystal Mary Cater.
Ivan Espinosa.
Kara Marie Aftermauer.
Haewon Jung.
Mia Young Mi Kim.
Jung Yoon Jin.
Yuri Ha.
David Michael Harrison.
Abir J. Zaytun.
John Andrew Lobb.
Emily Ann Collins.
Patrick Sun.
Jessica Mara Koki, magna cum laude.
Esther Yu.
Taylor Lauren Cartmill.
Rochelle Charisse Mallorca.
Stephanie Renee Jackson.
Andrew Michael Siegel.
Betty Yuchi Chang.
Bijal V. Shaw.
Takuya Nanchati Toride.
Jade Yen.
Daniel Mudell Jung.
Jason Young O.
Christopher Cartman Lee.
Kin Tai. Tinyan Bonnie Shu.
Gabby Gawing Kwan.
Wing Yin Vivian Cho.
Amy Lee.
Jenny Ying Diao.
Stanley Chan, cum laude.
Michelle Placencia.
Andrew Derringer, magna cum laude.
Karen Zhang.
Jeff Canister, cum laude.
Rosa Chu.
Kiyomi Nakatuzi, summa cum laude.
Samit Patel.
Jessica Yumi Song.
Lion Chu.
Tiffany Ting Ting Sai.
Lisa Akemi Hida.
Benson Su.
Yoshiko Maniwa.
Zoe Long.
Lulu Xiaoyin Lu.
Colette Wang.
Nina La, cum laude.
Shirley Yang.
David John Dory.
Rebecca Truax.
Ryan Nino Franco.
Richard Liu.
Christina Marie Hernandez.
Christopher J. Kim.
Owen Marshall Keeley.
Kevin Dean White.
Sarah Leong.
Molly Barrett, cum laude.
Ben Zhuang.
Amanda Marie Deanna.
Ryan On.
Ashley Marie Madrid.
Christina Lynn Davis.
Liliana Vanessa Dunan.
Allison Ray Arberg.
Nancy Romero, cum laude.
Casey Marie Lauritsen.
Andy Tran.
Christina Liu.
York William Sue.
Misty Dawn Mitchell.
Barrett Stingley.
Christina Tooch.
Lisa Marie Perez.
Heather Ann Dansel.
Danielle Simone Afif.
Maggie Garcia.
Chunfen Young.
Cassandra Lee Smith.
Joanna Lin.
Christian Carl Hankins.
Ian Brian McDonough.
Jason Cesar Dineros, magna cum laude.
Olivia Kuhn.
Dipesh Patel.
Ho-Yin Joe Low.
Kevin Joseph Gardner.
Fu-Yan Lo Kenneth.
Ellen Elizabeth Caprera.
Kathy C.
Brandon Fisher.
Eva Chong.
Thomas Mendez.
Mavis Sinsai.
Carlo Aldo Bonfante.
Yi-Sang Chan.
Trevor Allen Tyler, cum laude.
Shunwing Vivian Long.
Angel Paz, magna cum laude.
Manying Su.
Jessica Marie Horning.
Shunyin Mack. Kyle Lam. Yuchi Wang. Lisa Chang. Megan H. Wei. Philip Chuang. Raymond Wong. Steve John Park. Steve Lee. Walk and Win. Adriana Lee. Eva Huang. Austin Peterson Seo. Jin Young. Todd Mark Kojima. Raha Nabi. Amanda Pinkon Lynels. Janice Lee. Cherry Luck. Kelly Ho. Lilianti Asnawi. Christine Adesakiti. Ivasari Rianto. Vivian Cho. Moya Rufa. Michelle Emily Slater. Jeffrey Michael Elder. Courtney Leah Strickland. Sarah Kang. Nicole Siho Hong. Osman Muhammad. Christopher Tyrona Sangria. Thank you.
I can't hear you. Thank you. Please be seated. All of us here owe a debt of gratitude to the parents, husbands, wives, partners, and other significant family members who have encouraged, in many cases sacrificed, to make it possible for these graduates to attend college. We salute them and ask them to stand for a well-deserved round of applause from the class of 2009. Thank you. Please be seated. Students, you have worked long, hard hours for this degree, and you should be very proud of yourselves. Henry David Thoreau had it right when he said, "Go confidently in the direction of your dreams, live the life you have imagined." You are joining an elite group of alumni who have made significant contributions to the hospitality industry. I challenge you to go out there and make a difference, and I believe you can. On this note, I will conclude the Collins College of Hospitality Management commencement ceremony and wish you well for the next chapter in your lives. Thank you for being with us. Now, we do invite you to join us at a celebration reception immediately after this, and it will take place on the patio of the University Library down the walkway towards parking lot C. Will the audience please remain seated during the recessional?